Hey everyone, Kelsey here, and welcome back to Gal. Today I'm going to show you how to create the trippiest effect of this bus expanding to the back, like a stretch perspective effect. I saw this effect on Sex Education, the Netflix series. I'm seriously a fan of it because I've made another tutorial on one of the effects that's in the series. So the two students, they take some mushrooms in the back of the bus, and the bus just goes woo all the way back. And I was like, whoa, how did they do this? So I was playing around in After Effects and I figured it out. So I'm going to show you how to do some masking, duplication, some warping effects, and how to apply some cool chromatic aberrations using the script from my friends at Production Crate. Production Crate sponsored today's video. Production Crate is awesome. For a very small price or for their free assets, you can get hundreds and thousands of really cool visual effects. So you can create an effect like you're taking off like a witch. I created a tutorial on how to do that. They also have a really cool free hologram script, and I actually have a video where I have a hologram pop out of my hand, and so you'll learn how to do that. And I'm just, you know, a big fan and partner of Production Crate over the years. So if you're interested in trying out Production Crate, you can sign up for a free account or their pro plan just using my link down below. And without further ado, the time codes are just down below, and let's get trippin'. Let's start by clicking on the new comp icon. And for this, I'm going to make it 1920 by 1080 and 5 seconds in duration. I'm then going to drag in the sample bus photo into the composition. You can see it's much bigger, so I'm going to press S on my keyboard and use these controls to scale it back down into frame. Then we can adjust the anchor point. Press A on your keyboard, and then you can adjust the anchor point parameters to align with the top of the seats, as this is going to be the point where when we scale it back, it'll scale back exactly into this anchor point. Next, we can duplicate this layer by pressing Command D, and then we can rename the first one to be top and the one underneath to be bottom. Next, we're going to cut out the back of the bus on this top layer so it's like it doesn't have a back. If you're doing this with a video shot, to cut out the back of the bus, I would recommend using the rotobrush tool, because once you make that mask, it'll actually move with the video frame by frame. But this is just a photo, so we're actually going to just make a mask. So we're going to be using the pen tool. So we can zoom into the image and press G on the keyboard to activate the pen tool. And now I can quickly trace out the back of the bus. To make a curved path, click and hold. If you find that it's hard to see the color of the mask, you can go down to the layer, press M, and it will show you the mask path, and you can click on the color here and you can change it to a bright red color that's easier to see. Then we can go back to finishing up the mask, and you can always press H on your keyboard to go to the hand tool to move around, and then press G again to go back to the pen tool. So that's an easy way to move around as you draw the mask. And once it's done, we'll go back to the mask on the layer, and we're going to add a little bit of feathering, and then we can fit it back to frame and change the mask blend mode to subtract. Now, if we turn off the visibility of the bottom layer, you can see the back of the bus is completely transparent, and that's what we want. If you don't see the transparency grid here and just see black, it's still transparent, but if you want to see the transparency, just click here on this little icon. So to create the stretch back effect, we need to create duplicate layers and then scale these different layers back like an accordion stretching back. And I actually want to give a shout out to Tony C on Twitter, because I asked everybody on Twitter, I was like, hey, does anybody know the VFX artist that actually created this particular shot from the show? And Tony C stepped up and he's like, actually, I think I know how this might work. And he's the one that actually came up with this layering effect. And from there, we were able to collaborate and come up with this really cool effect. So that's why I love Twitter. It's awesome. So thank you, Tony C. Now let me show you how it works. All right, so to duplicate these layers, hit Command D 3 times, and then I'm going to move the layers down below the top layer and rename them to D1, D2, D3, and D is for duplicate. So with all these three duplicates plus the bottom layer selected, to select all of them, press Shift, and then you can press S on all of them to bring up the scale controls. And now we can press the stopwatch and it will create our starting keyframe on each layer. Then we can move the playhead to around 2 seconds where we want the animation to end. So for the first layer, we're gonna scale it down to 25%. And remember, the reason why it's starting at 45 is because we previously scaled the photo down when we first set up the comp, so it's completely fine that it's not starting at 100. So then for the next layer, D2, we can scale this down to around 16%. Then we can do the next layer at 10%. And then let's remember to turn back on the visibility of the bottom layer and let's scale it down to 5. Now as we play it back, you can see we're starting to get that really cool accordion stretch back effect. But depending on the seat height, we might also need to make adjustments to the position as well. So once again, select all the layers and then also press Shift P to bring up the position control. And here we can select the stopwatch again on all these position layers. Then let's pull the playhead to 2 seconds and then adjust the position up or down for each layer until it looks right. And you may not have to do this, it just depends on how well the anchor point was positioned. So now, to make the keyframing even smoother, let's lasso and select all of the keyframes here, and let's right-click and from Keyframe Assistant, choose Easy Ease. Also, make sure to select Motion Blur, so that way it's more natural of a movement, and now it's much more smooth. Right now it just animates back, but what if you want it to animate back in? So it's like a loop, so it's like an accordion, almost like the seats are breathing. So this is where we can loop the animation. So let's do that. So if you want to make it loop, let's move the playhead over 10 frames from the last keyframes we made. And with all 4 layers selected here, let's press the Add Keyframe button. Now we have another starting point. Then we can go back to the beginning and copy the position and scale keyframes for each layer. Then move forward 2 more seconds to complete the second animation, and let's paste those starting keyframes for each layer. Now, after it renders out, we can see we have our looping animation. So now that we have our foundational keyframes, now we can add some stylization, we can add some warping, and some cool RGB splits and chromatic aberration. First, let's start with some color correction. Let's right-click here and add an adjustment layer. From Effects, search for Lumetri, and add this to our adjustment layer. Now from Effect Controls, I'm going to use Lumetri's Creative section, and I'm going to choose one of the Lumetri looks. I'm going to try the SL Matrix Blue. And I think this looks a lot better, and I'm also going to add in some green tints to the highlights and some blue to the shadows. And lastly, I'll go down to Vignette to make some darker edges around the corners of the frame. I'm going to decrease the amount, reduce the midpoint, and also add some feathering. So this is what it looked like before, and now this is the after. And I think this coloring is definitely more cinematic, and it looks more creepy for the trippy effect that we're going to be adding. All right, now we're on to the warping. So first, let's select all the layers here, right-click, and pre-compose. Let's call this Bus FX, but you can name it anything that you want. Then go to Effects, and let's search for CC Scale Wipe. This is a really cool transition effect, but I found that we can actually use it to create a really cool warp effect around the edges. So go to the Scale Wipe, and here we can increase the stretch amount. I think around 1.25 is fine for this shot. And then you can play around with the direction, but I think the default here of 50 degrees is perfect. And you might have to press S to scale up the photo slightly so we don't see any transparency in the corner. And you may have to bring up the position controls by pressing Shift P to adjust the position as well. Now we can do the same thing for the right side. Let's right-click on this effect from Effect Controls and press Duplicate. And now all we have to do is change the direction from 50 degrees to negative 50. So it's being applied to the left side of the frame this time. And now it's warped, but we need to keyframe this stretch so that way it'll move over time to match the back movement. So let's bring up the effects on this layer. You can press E to bring up effects. Then you can move 2 seconds ahead in the timeline where this animation ends and press the stopwatch next to stretch on both layers. Then we can roll back to the beginning and set the stretch to 0. And now between these 2 keyframes, you have this really cool warping movement. And then just like before, we can complete the loop of the animation by pressing the keyframe icon again, go back and copy and paste the beginning keyframes, and paste it 2 seconds ahead, just like we did before. And also make sure that these keyframes are also easy ease and turn on the motion blur as well. So now we have the really cool backwards movement and the forward movement towards us with the chairs, but now we need to make it even more trippy by adding some really cool chromatic aberrations. So to create the RGB split effect, of course, you can do it from scratch. You can duplicate your layers and then you can add some shift channel effects, some 3D glass effects. It's a lot of tedious work. If you just want to apply one thing and bam, you have an RGB split, this is where I recommend using the Production Create Chromatic Aberrator script. You can just download it and they have a bunch of different styles to choose from. And the way that you open it up is you go up to File, and you go to Scripts and you run Script, and then it will open up a new window. So here you're going to select the footage or the composition you want to apply the aberration to. In this case, I'm going to apply two instances of this effect. So first, I'm going to choose the transform split method, and I'm going to increase the size to around 6 using this slider. And then hit create, and then you'll see that it pre-composed our comp and created another comp with all the effects applied. And it's definitely starting to look more trippy. So now I want to add in some waves to make it look more melty. So this time I'm going to select the comp again, but this time I'm going to choose the turbulent split method, and we can try out the default of 10. So while there was no waves in the sex education clip, I thought that adding the turbulent waves subtly makes it look a lot more cooler and melty. So I think 10 is a little bit too much, so I'm going to press Command-Z to undo that, and then I'm going to lower the amount to 6 and try again. So I think it's nearly there, but if you want to make any other customizations, you don't have to hit undo each time and reapply it. You can actually close the script window, and then you can go to these pre-composed comps here and select the Effects and Controls layer to modify the effects that were applied. So for this first one, you can lower this RGB split slider so that way it's not as intense. So it really depends on what you're going for. And then for the other composition, we can lower this slider to lower the amount of wave intensity that you see. So here is the look with some modified adjustments. Now, I think it's looking great, but to really, really sell it and to make it look more like a video and not just a photo with some movement forward and backwards, this is where we can add some fake camera movement. So to do this, first let's make this layer a 3D layer by clicking on this cube. Then we can go up to Layer, New Camera, and I'll be using the 35mm lens. Then, underneath the camera's transform tools, we can set a starting keyframe next to the camera's point of interest and position as the starting point. Then we can move the playhead to 2 seconds and we can press C on our keyboard until we get the camera dolly zoom control. So you can press C as many times as you need to until you get this dolly zoom icon, and then you can click and move forward and literally zoom forward. And you can also press C again to move the position of the point of interest. So now when we play this back and it renders out, we can see it has some real forward movement to create a little bit more trippy of an effect. And then we can repeat the reverse to complete the loop, so that way the camera will zoom back out. And finally, select all the keyframes, select Easy Ease for smooth movement. And now, with all of the effects combined, let's show you what our final effect looks like. So now this final effect, while it's not exactly the same as the sex education clip, I did add my own personal touch to it, and the concept is there. And now if you're shooting these scenes, you can start thinking about perspective shots. So if somebody's in a hallway, you can do this exact same effect. If somebody takes a drug and you want to have that point of view shot, you can really start to use these cool effects that I showed you to achieve your own trippy look. Once again, a huge thanks to Production Create for sponsoring today's video. And if you want my complete finished clip, as well as my After Effects project file that has all of the effects applied to it and my tutorial script for free to download, you can sign up to become a patron. I put my Patreon community link just down below. So that's all for today's video. Be sure to give it a big thumbs up and also subscribe and hit that notification bell so you're notified when I publish new videos on the channel. And as always, keep creating better video with Gal. See you next time. Bye.